Leicestershire is known for its remarkable musical life. It's largely the result of one man's labours, the late Eric Pinkett. He arrived in Leicestershire in 1948, at the same time as Mason, and as senior music advisor, he brought the same idealism to the county's musical life that Mason brought to its educational system.
He really had an incredible inventive genius, and his whole idea was that if the thing was going to be successful, children must be performing, they must have targets, they must be seen. And it wasn't just enough to play concerts. And he was managing to build up a most marvelous county enthusiasm, but gradually this developed into a great pageant in which music and dance and acting and were all interwoven. And how he persuaded a great family of schools to take part in it, I don't know, but in some of these pageants, I guess something like 2,000 children came together to perform.
Pinkett conjured instruments from junk shops, parents' attics, cupboards and basements. Local businessmen gave money, and the authority joined the wave of enthusiasm he'd unleashed.
Well, Eric Pinkett was a very eupeptic and immensely lively person who had a dream. And the dream was that given the chance in an education authority that had a real interest in the arts as part of education, and music particularly, and given a director of education who was willing to help him in dealing with the political problems, he could build up something that would be quite exceptional in the country and would have a foundation so solid that it would go on as a memorial to himself. And all I can tell you about Eric is that he did it.
When I first started, the important thing was to have enthusiasts. And so I had a lot of people working with me who had terrific enthusiasm and no ability. But give me the enthusiast with ability and we can do marvels.
In 1965, Sir Michael Tippett became the orchestra's patron and for several years one of its regular conductors.
Every Saturday, at the cost of the authority, coaches and buses go to fetch the children from all over the area and brings them to a large campus of comprehensive schools where it is possible to have as many as three orchestras. So all through the school year, on the Saturdays, you see, they are working away under the county music advisor, conducting them. And if I have agreed beforehand as to what should be done for a specific occasion, then we meet together.
As far as all the children that we are concerned with, of course, it is their life. And I believe I know it's altered their life, and there are many that I can tell you of who, because of music, have become different people. But I don't think it's music that does this. I think if you're a good gardener or if you're a good footballer, all this can relate to your life. I think it's a matter of if you can show a child how to do something well, then he'll do other things well.
Thank you.
Thank you. Just that you hear yourselves as a quartet, if you wish. Well, they've already done this before, but I want it done in such a way that you know you're going to play and you're an accompaniment to something going on. Okay, here's 207. Just these people alone. Nobody else. Right, go. Here it is, piano subito. Now feel the upbeat of the steep come one.
That's it. Now keep that sort of tempo all the time. Now go on to 208.
But if I'm thinking in sounds, I don't automatically think in notations at all. So at that point, the piano would be an assistance. Of course, the piano doesn't make the notes that the... I can't lay out a full score on a piano. I can play the piano to sound like a full score, but it's a different matter. But I then produce a kind of chemozzle of sound within which my ear gains, for the moment, this notational sense. I then know from the score exactly what it sounds like. There's no question about it, but I could never do it off the cuff.
Thank you. 4C4H.
The Leicestershire School Symphony Orchestra, one of the most outstanding groups of young musicians in the country.
Listen A, please, and piano. Good A
now. In the past year, they've played in London and Vienna, made a gramophone record, and even had their own festival in Leicester. The emphasis is very much on modern music, and in this they've been greatly helped by their patron, Sir Michael Tippett, who frequently conducts the orchestra.
Well, take the ives then from two ives, from two vowels of 4H. This gentle quiet sound, okay, as quiet as you can get it at the start. And let the solo flute come forward, go.
Putnam's Camp, from the suite Three Places in New England by Charles Ives.
The child is going to sleep and dreaming before the trumpets and all the army come over the hill. Okay? So this is a much dreamier sound, from lighter strings, little bit more flute, little bit more oboe at the solo. And then this chunk, chunk, chunk is the army gradually appearing, and that trumpet just playing a tiny bit of the grenadiers. So let's have it again now, and start as gently as you can in a really dreaming sound. Just falling asleep, go. Ooh.
There's no other country, except perhaps Canada, in which there is this fantastic activity in state schools, where the whole thing is sort of singing and burgeoning with a sort of sound. And this is not only making musicians, the top cream who will go to be professional musicians or go into musicology even, or whatever it's teaching, but the others who will go into offices or to factories or whatever, but who want to play, you see. Well, what the hell? If somebody wants to play here and hundreds of people want to play, why shouldn't I go and play with them?
You must try and get disentangled some of the tunes to come together. So let's have it once. Let's have a trumpet, please. Let a trumpet at O. Hear exactly what I really want to come flying out right above the other. The grenadier tune, which that army alone play, the Army of Independence. Okay, go. Yum. Now, that must be heard by everybody, you see. So don't knock the other one down. Let's have piano, top strings, please. Two violins and piano. The other tune, which means we come against it, but not overwhelm it. Go. Yum. Mm-hmm. Now just let the trumpet ride on the hole on top of that. So let's go back a wee bit till it comes in. Let's go from letter N, where the whole full army band is there. Right, go! Yeah.
Later in the year, Tippett and the orchestra are going to Berlin, but this month they're playing in Bath, at the festival of which Tippett has himself recently been appointed director.
Thank you. 10th Symphony, take one.
Havergal Brian is 96 years old. He was born in 1876 and he's been composing all his life, even though he's been utterly ignored almost all the time, both by the musical profession and by the public. Now, in 1972, the very first commercial recording of any of his music is underway, supervised by a fellow composer and unflagging enthusiast, Robert Simpson.
I think it's so original. I think he's one of the most original composers that this country's ever produced. And that goes right back. I think he's a fantastically original composer. He's quite unpredictable. You never know exactly what's coming next. And it's always something stranger and more remarkable than you expect.
It's ironic that the orchestra for this recording session is not a professional group, but the Leicestershire School Symphony Orchestra, most of them at least 80 years younger than the composer. Their conductor here is Eric Pinkett, the man responsible for creating the orchestra and its truly remarkable performance standards.
Sixth bar, that first C. Boom. Now, come on. Keep it. Thing, sorry to plague you. When you have a very, very long note, a breve tied to a minim, the sound unconsciously gets softer. You let the bow run out and you make it get softer. Keep the sound. No matter how long it is, if you have to go into free bowing at the moment, we won't care. Anything, but keep that sound. Same place and we'll go to the end. And one. Keep it. Can I ask you something? It's a small point. That's so nicely played, both from the flute and the clarinet. Play it a little freer. There you can afford to be a little freer within the bar. In other words, if you feel, only if you agree, if you feel like making the tiniest, most imperceptible tenuto on the first of the group of four semiquavers. Da 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 deem, dee da da. I don't care if you fall infinitesimally behind the beat, as long as you make up for it then, you know? But it's so pretty that way. Can we try right where the tune is over at 28? 28. And one. It says pianissimo, not mezzo forte. Last two bars. No, it says pianissimo. Stay there. Last two bars. Bravo. Bravo. Let's take a short break, shall we?
Rehearsals were sufficiently advanced to try out some of the dances with the orchestra. Complex cross rhythm presents probably the most difficult technical problem of the whole ballet for conductor Eric Pinkett and for Mary Hockney. It is astonishing that these schoolchildren, who play together only once a week, can cope with a score that would daunt even a professional orchestra.
Go over. Wait, can you hear it? mess of it. It was messy, wasn't it? We're not finishing absolutely spot on with you.
Okay.
Can we do it again?
Yes.